Many of us love summer, but so do annoying pests that can attack your trees, leaving them nibbled, naked, and near death. Residents in Ann Arbor are fighting a big outbreak of gypsy moths. Some call it the worst in 20 years. Paula Tutman takes a look at how humans and Mother Nature can fight back.
I need to warn you, the thing about watching this story is it's probably going to make you itch. And you know what rhymes with itch, right? Ick.
There are more and more of those egg masses.
Yeah. The circle of life is playing out in Bob Gavin's Ann Arbor yard.
Well,
like, oh, look at all the butterflies.
So, here's
not so much.
Yeah.
Gypsy moths are at an all-time high. Two fairly dry summers have boosted the population. This is actually a female laying her eggs. The males get excited and dance around frantically. They defoliate the trees in the process, and they poop.
If you come out at night, you have to wear a hat, and you definitely don't look up. And it's like rain.
The important thing is to know that this is cyclical in Michigan. And if you keep the base of the tree healthy,
trees that are healthy can be defoliated and will reflush and put out a new set of leaves, and there won't be any consequences next year.
You also need to know what to look for as Mother Nature actually corrects herself. When the gypsy moth population gets too dense, nature sends out a natural fungus and a virus. And so caterpillars hanging upside down like these need to be left alone on the tree so that other moths contract the fungus. Caterpillars twisted into a V also need to be left alone.
But keeping those dead caterpillars around will help to increase the virus and the fungus for the next year's population.
Technique I have been using is I pull off the female gypsy moth, and there's the egg mass. One egg mass can be between 600 and 1,000 potential caterpillars.
And while these gypsy moths can spread to other communities, it's part of nature. Little you can do to stop them, even less to get rid of them. The key is keeping the trees healthy in spite of them. Paula Tutman, Local 4.
We have a staff entomologist. That was
fascinating,
amazing,
right?
Stuff, wasn't it? You never knew. All right, Paula.